CT images are reconstructed from multiple projections by automated algorithms, the most common of which is back projection. The CT image slice we see here has been reconstructed from multiple projections at multiple angles. In high-resolution imaging sequences, this can be as high as 200 projections and down to 60 or even 30 projections for fast imaging. The number of projections influences the degree with which we can discern fine image structure. In general, the higher the number of projections, the better the resolution. In its most basic form, a CT image is constructed by taking multiple projections through an object. We then rotate both the source and acquisition sensors on a gantry around the subject, taking projections as we go. CT imaging machines also use a fan-shaped X-ray source and a matching arc-shaped sensor array. There are technical advantages to this approach that we won't detail here, but it should be noted that this also aids in keeping the rotating part of the machine compact. As the gantry rotates, multiple projections are then taken. In our case, we'll base our examples on 4 projections for simplicity, even though this number is very low. It is important to remember that the value the sensor will see at the red circled point is the sum of the attenuation that beam will experience as it passes through tissue. This single number is the only output data recorded, and as such, each projection will be a linear series of numbers across the sensor array. In order to demonstrate how we can now reconstruct projections, we will first need to recognize that CT images are represented as a grid of pixels, or voxels. Voxels are the three-dimensional version of pixels. Back projection algorithms treat images as a discrete set of voxels in order to perform the reconstruction. In our example, we will use a very simple 2x2 image with 4 pixel values, 5, 8, 3, and 2. We can now calculate what a projection will look like through this data from left to right. The attenuation in this case will be the sum of the elements in the direction of the projection, in this case 13 and 5. We now move on to the next projection, in which we will sum diagonally through the pixels, resulting in projection values of 8, 7, and 3. We continue for the vertical projection and remaining diagonal projection. What we have now is a set of 4 projections that are equivalent to the raw output of a CT machine from a 2x2 block of data. In order to reconstruct the original values in the block, from the 4 projections, we start with an empty 2x2 block. The first step is to fill the block with the values from the first projection in the direction of the projection that generated them. In our case, 13 in the top row and 5 in the bottom row. We then proceed to the second projection and add the values of this projection to our current result. In our case, we then add 8 from the projection to the existing value of 13 in the top right corner to give us 21. We then proceed with the projected value of 7 and add this to 13 and 5, resulting in 20 and 12. This projection is completed by adding 3 from the projection to the existing value of 5 to give 8. We then proceed to the next projection and add 8 to 20 and 8, resulting in 28 and 16. Add 10 to result in 31 and 22. The last projection is then added, giving us our final projection result. We then go back to the first projection and subtract the sum of this projection, in our case 13 and 5, resulting in 18, from each of the elements of our current projection. This gives us a new block of 15, 24, 9, and 6. The final step is then to divide by the number of remaining projections, in our case 3, to give us our final result that matches our original data. Multiple filtering steps can be added to this basic algorithm to remove noise and improve the result when there are only a small number of projections. But the main process still remains the same. These techniques are sometimes called filtered back projection.